Conexiones is made possible by
Brown Tax Services Incorporated. Understands its clients' needs and provides strategies to guarantee their money is in the right place. The expertise of Miriam Brown and her outstanding customer service make Brown Tax Services the right choice for your tax and accounting needs. Make every dollar count with the support of Brown Tax Services. For more information, call 504-362-0540 or visit miriambrown.com.
Bienvenidos a Conexiones, el programa de entretenimiento, información y educación de la cultura latina. Yo soy Ana María Beck. En este programa tenemos una gran variedad. Cineastas de Austin visitaron New Orleans para compartir su arte. Navegamos el ciberespacio para aprender más sobre el mundo blogging. Alex Cuba nos permitió entrar a su mundo y conocer a fondo su música. Y después nos fuimos de fiesta al Azúcar Bowl. Quédense conectados. Conexiones empieza ahora. South by Suroeste, cineastas de Austin compartieron su cine con nosotros. En el Centro Cultural de Arte de New Orleans se presentaron cortometrajes hechos por latinos y basados en la experiencia latina.
Mira, yo conocí a esta persona llamada Gerald White hace bastante tiempo, ¿no? Hace como unos 4 años. Y de ese momento nosotros siempre estuvimos en contacto. Él vive aquí en New Orleans y vive aquí allá en Austin, ¿no? Y siempre hubo la idea de repente hacer algo entre las dos, ciudades, ¿no? Porque, o sea, vamos a estar claros, o sea, en el sur, las dos ciudades más importantes, digamos, a nivel cultural, vienen siendo Austin y New Orleans.
We've done actually 2 events prior to this one, building up to it. And we just said, let's go for broke. Let's try and make these connections between New Orleans and Austin. And let's really showcase the amazing talent within both of our communities.
Empecé a hacer primero video art, colaborar con artistas en Houston. De ahí me volví a España y trabajé en documentales durante 4 años. Y luego decidí volver a Texas, me fui a la Universidad de Austin a estudiar cine, empecé a hacer cortometrajes y continué con los documentales y he hecho hasta ahora 5 cortometrajes y casi más de 100 documentales. Clowns Never Lie, ese cortometraje que hice cuando estaba todavía en la universidad, es sobre un joven inmigrante que tiene problemas con la esquizofrenia. Entonces, para conseguir dinero, él se sienta en la calle vestido como clown, pero no hace nada, simplemente se sienta. Y su vida es muy monótona hasta que un día aparece una joven que le saca de su monotonía.
I grew up in San Antonio, Texas, and I wanted to be an engineer. So my undergraduate degree is in engineering, and I worked for a couple of years doing that and then realized it was kind of boring. And so I went back and had a friend who was dabbling in some film classes in Austin. And so I just quit my job, moved to Austin, and started taking these nighttime classes in film. And made a short, and then made another short, playing some festivals. And then 12 years later, I'm teaching film at the university now and writing stuff. My short is called Kid, and it's about a 12-year-old boy who's kidnapped by his estranged father on the night before he turns 13. And I wanted to do something that was very decidedly South Texas and spoke to the South Texas culture, specifically how there's a machismo element in it and what it meant to be a man. And what it meant to have to be a man with your father as you hit adolescence. And part of it is autobiographical, part of it is not. But It was just something that I sort of wanted to talk about at the time when I made the film.
My name is Sharon Arteaga, and the title of the film is When I Grow Up. It's a short I shot 2 years ago in my hometown, Corpus Christi. It's based on my upbringing selling tacos with my mom out of a van. And my mom's actually in the film, and this was a Mother's Day gift that I made for her 2 years ago. I watched a lot of Disney growing up, and I just wanted to be a part of that magic of telling stories that were so captivating and moving. And then my dad had this chunky RCA camera, and he would just make home videos, and I would just love looking through the lens. Something inside me would just get all warm and fuzzy when I would hold the camera.
Si ponemos a Austin al lado de San Antonio, estamos hablando de, ponte, un 60-70% o más, ¿no?, de latinos en esa área, ¿no? Sin embargo, cuando hablamos de la parte de media, es bien pequeño el porcentaje, ¿eh? O sea, y eso a nivel de lo que sea, de Hollywood, o sea, estamos súper underrepresented, como dicen en inglés, o sea, no representados, ¿eh? Entonces la idea es, pues, vamos a empezar con algo que la gente no se espera. O sea, la gente no se espera de repente cine latino de Austin, ¿eh? De repente de San Antonio, pero no de Austin. Y yo estoy trabajando en Austin, Miguel trabaja en Austin, o sea, muchos de nosotros trabajamos en Austin, esa es la idea, ¿no?
It's great being from Austin, or particularly being from South Texas, and then coming to New Orleans, because you don't normally think of New Orleans and Austin as sort of sister cities, but they do have this sort of cultural background, each distinct to the city. And so it's really nice to be able to sort of bring part of our culture to New Orleans, and then hopefully in the future, bring part of that distinct New Orleans culture to Austin.
It's awesome. I when I was a little girl in a car selling tacos, like, I would have never imagined, you know, that I would end up going to college, going to University of Texas, and then being here in this great city, showing my film to people interested in watching it.